Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler. I want to take a few minutes to show you a really nice motorhome we just got in on trade. This is a 2011 Tiffin Phaeton. It's a 42 QBH. Nice bath and a half floor plan. Maybe you're thinking about stepping up a little bit in your coach, but really don't want to spend the money for a new coach. This would be a good opportunity. Really low miles, super clean coach. We just got it in, so we haven't had a chance to wash the outside, so kind of look beyond some of the road dust that's on this. But this, like I said, this would be a good opportunity. Tiffin's a great manufacturer. They build an awesome coach, stand behind it. They have one of the best reputations in the industry. That's why they've got three of the top-selling diesel motorhomes on the market are Tiffin motorhomes, which is says a lot about the company, especially since they're not a huge manufacturer, smaller family-run business. But they do a really nice job. Like, the fit and finish is awesome. They do a great job on their paint. They have a really upgraded paint facility that they've fashioned after Mercedes-Benz of North America, nice downdraft paint booths and that type of thing, so keeps things from floating around in the air when they're spraying paint. Each of these coaches has several coats of paint, and they also put a couple of coats of clear paint coat on these as well, sand them down, so you got a nice smooth finish. Side view cameras, you'll like having those. Easy access to get in. Plenty of storage in this one. Again, a 42 QBH, nice big size propane tank. There's your hydraulics for the slides and your auto leveling jacks. You've got two slide out trays. These are nice because they'll go either direction. Makes it easier to get to your stuff in there. It's a raised rail chassis, so you do have an extended height in your compartment here, your storage compartment. There's a little ladder in the back there too for getting on the roof. So with these two trays, you can get a lot of stuff back underneath there. Outside TV. So if you have a notion to maybe sit out here, want a nice evening and watch a movie or take in the ball game, you have access to that. Real easy to get to that. Big patio awning, all electric. You do have a door awning too, so there's two different awnings. One comes over the door and one is for your patio side. Notice all the slide outs have awnings, covers over those too. Alloy wheels. And back here we've got just a couple of small compartments. That one's for your diesel emission fluid. Some of your electronic stuff here. Hopefully you don't have to mess with that very much. 380 horsepower coming, so you got good power plant, turbo diesel. One thing that's really, I think, worth pointing out too on the Tiffin motorhomes is they use a one-piece fiberglass roof. So you've got, and it's reinforced where it's molded, so this is actually formed before they drop it on the coach. It's going to be formed across the top, and then it comes down to the sides. As you can, if you can swing your camera around here, you can kind of see where it makes that turn, where it meets the sidewall. So that area up in there is reinforced with extra fiberglass, so it's a lot thicker, because that's the stress point on a motorhome when it's going down the road. You know, things are going to move around a little bit. So they do a nice job of reinforcing the roof. Having a one-piece fiberglass roof leaves less to worry about that could go wrong on the up there, like leaks or that type of thing. Pretty low maintenance too. Again, more storage over here. There's your chassis batteries. Got two chassis batteries. House batteries are up front. Tag axle gives you a little more stability if you're going to be hauling a little bit more weight. There's your wet bay. Notice that's nice and easy, clean, very user-friendly. You got the outside shower there, hookup for your sewer. Whole house water filter too, which is nice. So all your water coming into your coach will be filtered. And then I like the fact that you put your water pump right out there, easy to get to in case you need to do some servicing there. This is where your power cord is going to be, right in there. 50 amp power. And then both sides of the other side of your slide out trays. If you can swing your camera down in here, up in there, you can see there's where your inverter is. has a 2000 watt inverter. Run those electronic devices that you might want to run when you're dry camping and don't have to run your generator that way. There's, and you can see tons of storage. I think this one's going to be where your house batteries are. Should have 6 house batteries in there. These are locked and I don't have the key to get in there right now. And this is just access to more fuses and the release for your generator. You have a 10K generator up front. You got a nice diesel O&N generator. Nice colors, really nice paint. The coach has been really well cared for. Now you probably have other questions, so feel free to give me a call. I'll probably miss some things that you'll want to know about. So you can reach me on my direct line at 541-510-1017. Well, let's go take a look inside. So the unit's back in the detail area here, just waiting to get cleaned up. It's not going to need a lot, but we're going to make sure this thing's standing tall when you take delivery of it. Easy access to control panel here. I can turn my water heater on here. The controls for my awning. The gen starts right here. It does have auto gen start also, so you can program this to start your generator at certain times or maybe when your battery gets down to a certain level. Control, slide out controls here, awning controls, all that's right here. I can check my tank levels from right here also. We do have a TV up front. Get more storage. Tiffin does their own cabinets too. They have their own cabinet shop. They do a lot of what they put in these motorhomes, they do themselves. They're what they consider to be vertically integrated. So they're not just a manufacturer that buys parts from somebody and assembles them. They manufacture a lot of what they put in their coaches themselves. So that gives them a lot more consistent quality, and it's easier for us to get parts. If you and I own one of these and we need a part for something, if they manufactured it, even if they didn't have it in stock, they could reproduce it. They even do their own windows. So they make their own windows at their own plant too. Built on a Freightliner chassis, I mentioned 380 horsepower Cummins. You got a good power plant, mated with a 6-speed Allison transmission. This thing drives like a dream. Like I said, maybe you're looking to upgrade a little bit. You're in a smaller coach. Maybe you're in a gas coach. Now you want to go diesel. Air ride, air brakes, and just makes it a completely different experience than a coach that's, you know, going to be on springs. Adjustable foot pedals. Telescoping wheel, tilt wheel, so you've got a lot of conveniences to make it real comfortable when you're out on the road. It does have an engine brake, looks like it's a 2-speed engine brake, not just an exhaust brake, but an actual engine brake. Works off the compression of the engine, so you can really slow yourself down if you're going down a steep grade, maybe you're pulling something heavy behind you. Auto level is nice, got the HWH hydraulic leveling system. Controls are easy to get to. Everything's right here. You got your backup camera, triple vision, so you got side view cameras, backup monitor back there, and your radio, and all your electronics are kind of right there, easy to get to. Both front seats, of course, are going to spin around. Really nice seats. They use flex steel furniture in here. Does have a sleeper sofa, so you got a sleeper there. So if you have guests that want to come stay with you, you have the ability to put them up somewhere. This does have nice MCD shades, day and night shades. So this one comes down too, so you've got the ability to block out some of the sun. These are tinted windows too, so that'll help keep the sun from getting too intense in here. But having those shades really helps. Look at all that storage. Tons of storage in this thing. Nice and deep, come out here quite a ways. I utilize the space really well. Again, fit and finish is nice. Notice the hidden hinges. Nice, really residential look and appeal. Great kitchen area, lots of counter space. Does have a 3-burner stovetop and a convection microwave oven. You got a pull-out countertop extension here also. So it gives me a little bit more workspace in here. Drawers come out a ton. And if I don't want it out here, I can just push it in out of the way. Notice you've got plug-ins right there, so you got a couple of 110 outlets to be able to plug your appliances in. Even has a little speaker underneath here, it looks like, for your stereo. Double sinks, nice two big stainless steel sinks. Looks like it's got a soap dispenser and a sprayer. Also, room underneath here for maybe a garbage can. More storage. Actually, they do have a place in here. This one does have a built-in garbage can, so that's nice. So you could use this for another, actually put an oven in here if you wanted a propane oven, or maybe even a, if you wanted to add a dishwasher, you could. These are nice. But again, they do all this stuff in-house, so the quality is really outstanding. Another TV here. Lots of lighting, lots of drawers. You know, this is a great coach if you're thinking about maybe doing some more extended traveling. The fantastic fan vent moves a lot of air right here in your galley area. You're going to have one in your bathroom. This is, I mentioned, bath and a half, so I think this one has three fantastic fan vents. And on the driver's side, I've got the two recliners. So you've got good seating, nice comfortable seating. Looks like it's got all the original manuals and everything. And here's the deal, if you buy today, just this special deal, we're going to throw in some Simply Granola oats, honey, and almonds. So that's part of the deal. So just make sure you mention that when you come in to buy the coach, that you want that box of cereal. Well, like I said, we haven't had a chance to clean it out yet. It even has some raisins. So you can see that the people ate pretty healthy that own this coach, traded it in. They bought a brand new Allegro 45. They went into a 45 bus, so they just were ready to upgrade. The table setup is nice. It's got a tabletop extension. There's two more chairs that are down under the bed, fold-up chairs. So you've got seating for four. This is what they consider to be the computer workstation dinette. So it has a little deeper shelf up here, and then you've got some pull-outs that you can use to set up a workstation. So if you want to maybe have your computer down here, there's power down under there too, so you can plug in your appliances. You got a little additional storage, and I think over on the other side here also you've got a couple drawers, plus down here, yeah, a little file cabinet. So beautiful coach. You know, not too dark. It's got a nice finish to it. Big refrigerator. This is a residential style refrigerator. Sure, the size, I'm going to guess 22 cubic feet. It could be off by a little bit, but it's big, as you can see. Got a huge freezer. You got ice down here also. We're going to clean this up inside and out. It's going to get a good detail for you. We make sure you get a good orientation also. How about that? Having a nice little pull-out pantry too. Great place to put some of your spices. Before we go back into the bedroom area, you do have the front bathroom. So I've got a toilet and a sink in here. It's extra storage. They do have the other fantastic fan vent there. And on this other side of the hallway, I've got washer and dryer. So you got stackable separate washer and dryer all ready to go. So the bedroom area has a king size bed. So the slides, you have two slides in here, so this opens up nicely. I like to have windows on both sides too, and both of those windows open up so you can get some fresh air. That's a nice fan up here also with the control right next to the bed. And I mentioned storage underneath the bed. So there's your other chairs for your dinette, and then down here, I guess that's just some wrapping paper. So it does have central back also in this one. Lots of drawers. I think you mentioned, you know, they're nice metal glides, so you've got full extension drawers. Storage up here. Another bedroom TV. It's wired for, you know, if you want to put another device back here, like a satellite receiver, or maybe a DVD player. Looks like it has a sound bar with it also. And then in the very back, as we step up here, we've got, with its own doors, got a nice full bathroom back here with two sinks, nice countertops. So it looks like this is a, with a, that fantastic that fan, it's, you know, going to have a lot more airflow back here. And you got plenty of drawers, lots of cabinets, and a full closet back here also. Looks like your fuse panel. Or breakers, I guess, if you need to get to that. And then there's fuses over here also. It's kind of nice being out of the way, but you can get to it easy enough if you need to. And 42 QBH, the model number. Nice stand-up shower. Tag axle gives you the ability to load more in here. So maybe you're looking to hit the road, spend a little bit more time out traveling. You want to haul a little bit more with you. Maybe you're even thinking about going full time. So this would be a good choice. 2011, so it's new enough to be in really good shape still. As you can see, you know, we haven't really started the process of getting it all detailed up. This is pretty much the way we got it in. So it's a nice coach and something that I think you'll really enjoy. So give me a call if you have some other questions, or maybe you want to see what we can do about getting into this. You can reach me on my cell phone. It's 541-510-1017. Thanks.